Good evening, seniors. Class of 2014, the first class to ever graduate from Columbia Secondary School. We finally made it. It took us 7 years, but we did it. I'd like for all of you to take just a moment to remember when you first stepped foot into 425 West 123rd Street as a member of our community. Whether you came that very first day of Bridge to School in 2007, or sometime between then and 11th grade, were you excited, surprised, nervous, scared, sweaty, out of breath? Well, to be honest, I was all those things on my first day. Five flights of stairs with an overloaded backpack is no easy feat. And then, to have your picture taken right afterwards and put on the online school directory as a means for everyone else to identify you? Yikes. So many things have changed since our first days. We're no longer classified as Da Vincians, Newtonians, or Darwinians. No more think sheets on the hallway floors. We don't tuck in our shirts. Hot lists in the bathroom and month-long rubber band wars are a memory. We have had so many accomplishments and goals met, including our first students to take Columbia University classes, our musicals, our plays, our sports teams, our boys and girls rugby championships, our college acceptances, and our first prom, and of course, our lockers. There's so much to remember as we come together today. One of the defining aspects of Columbia Secondary School is the adversity we faced. From the beginning, we were criticized. We were doubted when we proposed that with one of the most diverse groups of students in the city, we would accomplish wonders, such as performing at the high level of other more established schools, attending Columbia University classes with other college students, and getting accepted into high-profile universities. There was a time when Columbia Secondary School was on a steep downward slope. Many faculty, administrators, and students left and joined other school communities. Many of us who decided to stay thought about the possibilities of leaving. I know I did. I thought to myself, what if I was in a different high school? What if I went to a more established institution that didn't have to go through this? What if I had never joined CSS? What kept us here? For me, it was hope. Hope that the school would get back on track. Hope that we would accomplish everything that everyone else said we could not. Hope that despite overwhelming odds, we could graduate knowing that we left behind the foundation to an institution that will last many generations. The night is darkest just before the dawn. For a while, we didn't see the dawn coming, but like it always has, and it always will, the dawn arrived. Our hopes were realized because we acted upon them. We didn't wake up finding ourselves taking Columbia University courses or getting ready to attend amazing colleges. We worked through the night for that opportunity, and we finally earned it. Everyone has had difficulties while being here, but we've conquered them together, and we can be proud of that. They've prepared us well for our forthcoming college life and the real world. In reality, things might not always go the way we expect or hope they will. I've learned a bit about that here at CSS, but I'm proud of it because it's made me into a better person. I've learned that when things don't go the way I like them, it isn't effective to dwell on why they happened or whose fault it is or what will eventually result from it. Rather, we need to look forward to making the situation better. This approach helped me personally succeed in my CSS and Columbia University coursework, and I believe that for all of us, it could be an effective approach to college. With all of our college acceptances to Ivy Leagues, state schools, liberal arts colleges, and other excellent public and private universities, with some of us being awarded scholarships and full tuition, we have opened doors that will reveal opportunities, friends, connections, and career paths for us to take. Writer Joseph Campbell said, quote, "You must give up the life you planned in order to have the life that is waiting for you." This isn't saying that it's a bad idea to have a general direction that we'd each like to go in these next few years. Rather, it's saying that there are so many factors that we can't predict about the future, and we should be prepared to adapt. Evolution, right? And evolution, it is. Adapting to college will be difficult. But remember that everyone else in your new college class is going through the same process. And in some ways, we've been given a head start on our own evolutionary processes. Like our first day at CSS, we'll still have a first day where we feel a bit uncomfortable. But that day will be with new people. Like our first day at CSS, we'll still be walking up many stairs, but they will be the stairs of a college building or a dormitory. Like our first day at CSS, we'll be excited, surprised, nervous, scared, sweaty, and out of breath. But hopefully, this time we won't have our pictures taken when we look like that. College life will be foreign, but our evolution will be familiar. We can adjust to change. We can make better habits. We can work harder. We can love more people. And we can be successful in all facets of our lives. And then, there will be times when we will glance back into the past. We will see the school that we created, and the fruits of our labors will be there for new generations to enjoy. We will visit our school, and new students will let us know what they've achieved, and we will listen to them, knowing in the back of our minds that we began this chain reaction of success. I quoted Joseph Campbell earlier. He was the writer that identified the hero's journey archetype, one of the most epic ideas in all of literature. The students of CSS are the heroes of a unique epic journey, and we followed all of the stages of this archetype. We began in the ordinary world as normal New York City kids. We got our call to adventure when we discovered how much work was needed to make CSS into a great place. Some of us initially refused that call because we anticipated its immense difficulty. We were mentored and trained by professors and teachers, and we learned how to improve our community. With this, we crossed a threshold and left the comfort of apathy to move forward to create an effective high school student government, musicals, plays, philosophy roundtables, school clubs, newspapers, sports teams, and more. We were tested when many of our ideas were put down and when our hard work seemed to be for nothing. But we approached these tests together and sacrificed our personal doubts in order to create a school spirit that will last forever. We confronted our fears that this might never happen, and we were relieved when it finally did. Now that we've claimed our rewards, now that we have our school pride, now that we've completed high school, we will be on the road back home. We will face more challenges, and we will have to make more sacrifices at higher levels. But they will be easier because of what we've already experienced. Then, someday, we will return to our original world, our original city, our home, and we will change that world with the rewards that we've earned. No matter how much we change the world, however, we will always remember that we started on 425 West 123rd Street. We will remember the school that we created. Our motto has always been, we build CSS together. But tonight, the class of 2014 can proudly say, we built CSS together. Thank you.